Anthony Albanese and Bill Shorten have gone head-to-head in the first Labor leadership debate. After first agreeing both would be good leaders, they pitched their objectives to build Labor's future.
My platform in nominating for the leadership of the Federal Parliamentary Labor Party goes to issues of the party, the policies and the people.
I'm putting myself forward on a platform of providing vision, unity and strength.
A Morgan poll shows Mr Albanese is the preferred candidate. Labor members and the caucus will vote on October 10. Julie Bishop has been put to the test as Australia's new foreign minister, forced to play down disagreements with Indonesia over asylum seeker policy at the UN General Assembly in New York.
Our relationship with Indonesia is much broader than the one issue of border protection.
Ms Bishop met with nine other foreign ministers today. On Thursday, she'll chair a UN Security Council meeting. Police are searching for an armed gang who held up a Sydney cinema. Police say the group of teenagers stormed the Roseville Theatre and demanded cash from moviegoers and staff.
One had a hatchet, machete-type hatchet, and the other had a sawn-off shotgun. They threatened them that we'll kill you or shoot you if you don't hand over your money.
They fled in a car they had stolen earlier from 87-year-old Philip Brighton. They then robbed a pub at Revesby. The car was later found burnt out nearby. A student pilot from New South Wales has died in a light plane crash in Western Victoria. The 20-year-old was finishing night training when his single-engine Cessna went down in a paddock near the Hamilton airfield.
There were no other actual aircraft involved in this incident. However, there were another number of other students in the vicinity of the airport and also participating in training programs.
Investigations are underway into what caused the crash. Security video has captured a violent armed robbery in Adelaide. A service station worker was confronted by three men, one armed with a knife. The 20-year-old is knocked to the ground and slashed as he tries to defend himself.
I'm fearing for my life at this point. Knife right in front of me. I'm shocked. Couldn't say anything. All I'm hearing is, give us the money. Where's the money?
The men fled with cash and remain on the run. The attack is one of six robberies across Adelaide in the past week and a half. Dr. Jayan Patel has pleaded not guilty to the grievous bodily harm of a patient. Ian Val had his bowel removed in 2004. Prosecutors allege the surgery carried out by Dr. Patel was unnecessary. Mr. Val's lawyers say he suffered permanent damage and was unable to return to work. He's expected to give evidence tomorrow. Lawyers for Darren Hinch say extensive media coverage of the Jill Maher case will make it difficult to prove his blog could have influenced the trial. The 69-year-old is facing two contempt of court charges for an editorial about Ms. Maher's killer, Adrian Bailey. It included details of his previous rape convictions. Hinch's lawyers claim that other media had the potential to prejudice the case. The trial continues. Cathy Freeman has revealed she suffered chronic asthma at the height of her sprinting career. The Olympic gold medalist is backing a new device to help monitor the condition by sending information to a smartphone app. While she struggled with asthma since her teens, she was only formally diagnosed 6 years ago.
I'm sure if I had known what I know now, I would have, who knows, run faster than what I actually did.
Freeman's sister died of an asthma attack in 1990. Former Queensland Premier Anna Bligh has opened up about her battle with cancer. In an interview to mark the 80th birthday of the Australian Women's Weekly, she talks about undergoing surgery and chemotherapy. The ex-politician says she invited friends and family over for a bottle of champagne when she shaved her head. She revealed in June she was diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma.